The financial law firm Marson and Lormont were just doing the legwork for a big homegrown multinational. They sent their best corporate attorney, Kate Walker, to Europe to negotiate the takeover of the Vorarlberg automaton and mechanical toy factory. Kate slinked into the village of Valladolid, deep in the French Alps. She reckoned on 48 hours to close the deal. But then, nobody had reckoned on there being an heir. Hans Vorarlberg, a mysterious character, had disappeared years earlier. Kate had to find him. Without his signature, the deal was off. She checked out the abandoned factory and met the latest generation of automaton. He called himself Oscar and claimed to be the engineer of the crazy locomotive in the station. So Kate decided to hop on, hoping the train and its wheelman could take her to their maker, Hans Vorarlberg. Ignoring the warnings of her friends and the threats of her boss, she takes off on a bizarre journey, rolling from station to station, further and further towards the east. On the trail of Hans Vorarlberg's past, Kate's route is littered with his crazy inventions and the recollections of people who had come across the little madcap guy. She finds out that he was a creative genius. Piece by piece, she put together the puzzle of Hans's life and discovered the reason for his flight northwards through the Russian interior towards the myth of the last surviving mammoths. West to east, across Europe, traveling along the battle scars of the 20th century, Kate finally collars her man, Hans Vorarlberg. Time, though, had caught up with him first. He is old and tired, yet his wildest dreams shine on. Apparently, Kate Walker has bid farewell to her old life and decided to follow Hans Vorarlberg to the end of his personal rainbow, right to the legendary island of Syberia.
Have you heard anything about Kate Walker?
No, sir. Nothing yet.
She should have been back in New York several weeks ago.
I'm afraid she's too far gone. We're losing her. She ain't gonna be coming back.
Call her!
Syberia is an island. An island lost in the ocean. People say Syberia doesn't exist, but people are so wrong. The isle is covered in the tallest grass. Strange grass that grows through the snow. Mammoths eat it all the time. They're always hungry.
Hans, you must rest now. You have a very high fever.
Take me to Syberia, Kate Walker.
Mammoths, Syberia, all that. It's just a dream, a kid's dream.
Promise me, Kate.
She's not behind her messages, sir.
Try again, damn it, try again!
Hello? Miss Walker? Just a moment, please.
Give me that. Kate? Come on now, pet, answer me. I understand your last mission was a hassle for you. But you know, the company has ways of showing its gratitude. Kate, it's time for you to come home now. Your place is here, in New York. Your job is here. Your friends are here. Your life. Kate?
Kate? Kate Walker!
I promise, Hans Vorarlberg. We're going to Syberia.
Hi.
Hello there, Kate Walker.
Hans, where are we?
Somewhere on the way to Syberia.
Is it still far?
Pretty much.
Nobody's ever seen this island. No explorers ever talked about it. And, well, It's not on any map, Hans.
I know Syberia exists, Kate Walker.
I don't mean to get personal, but don't you think that this journey's going to be a bit tough for a man your age?
I am going to Syberia, Kate Walker. End of discussion. You do understand.
When are we leaving again?
I want to leave as quickly as possible, but it's Oscar who decides. He's the master of the train.
Do you think that the train can go much further? There's more and more snow, and the cold is biting.
I designed and built it, Kate. You did remember to wind it.
No, not yet.
Then get it wound and let's be off.
So, how do we wind the train here?
There's a train winder at the head of the platform. Ask Oscar, he'll show you.
See you later, Hans.
Yes, see you later.
Hans's mammoth doll. Hans's cylinder machine. Something else he's slapped together since we came on board. Hello?
Kate Walker? This is Oscar calling, your driver.
Oscar? You're using a telephone?
Mr. Vorarlberg has, in effect, jerry-rigged me something very approximative, inspired by your own miniature device. Mr. Vorarlberg is such a repository of knowledge. I am calling to inform you that we have arrived at the station, Kate Walker.
Great. Which station's that?
The station is located in the town of Romansburg, Kate Walker.
Okay. I'm gonna go snoop around.
Do be careful, Kate Walker.
Always am, Oscar.
Have reached Marson and Lormont Associates. All our lines are busy at the moment. Please try again later.
Why do I even keep trying this number?
Oh, hello. I'm going away to the Hamptons, but I'll be back midweek. Call me then. Au revoir.
Mom's not at home. She'd have never understood why I'm still here anyway. It's a little chilly to be taking a shower. Thanks all the same.
Welcome to Romansburg, the last town before the vast wild glacial wastes of the tundra. Retired Colonel Emilyov Lupachev, guardian of the Imperial Marches, and general store manager at your service, miss. How may I?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the frontier town of Romansburg, gateway to the tundra, the last town before the vast plains of the frozen wastes.
I might as well be a snowman.
What a welcome. Nothing I can do. It's locked.
Thank you.
What a strange town. What do you make of it, Oscar?
Trains should never have to stop. I simply don't like stations, Kate Walker, nor the towns around them.
That's a little bit of a generalization.
The whole town is lugubrious, and I don't like these houses underneath the rails. To me, they spell T-R-O-U-B-L-E. We have to be very careful.
Uh-huh, still the same old scaredy cat.
I cannot change my design, Kate Walker.
Oscar, is your train in a fit state to carry on with the journey?
What are you suggesting, Kate Walker? I take the greatest care of it.
Yes, I know, Oscar. But I was just thinking that with this rude climate...
It is designed to resist just such conditions, Kate Walker. You simply have to wind it up.
And you weren't thinking by any chance of taking charge of that yourself?
My wheelwork is complex and fragile. It is poorly adjusted for the rigors of winter, Kate Walker.
Now there's a surprise. Hans isn't looking so great, don't you think?
While his passion is strong, his wheelwork is worn, Kate Walker.
Yeah, I guess so. Sometimes I say to myself I should just go back to New York.
Do you miss it, Kate Walker?
I don't know.
I don't think you will ever return home, Kate Walker. It is too late now.
Oscar, how come you're programmed for psychology all of a sudden? Do you think that we're any nearer to our goal, Oscar?
It is getting colder. That much is certain. Personally, I have no particular goal, Kate Walker. But the train and myself have not been designed to function forever. I would be grateful if you could talk about this matter with Mr. Vorarlberg, and him alone, if you please.
Sometimes I say to myself that it's all just a figment of my imagination, that Siberia is just a pie in the sky.
You ask yourself the strangest questions, Kate Walker. I am particularly piqued that you question my reality for an instant, even more so that you question that of Mr. Vorarlberg.
I'm sorry, Oscar. That was dumb of me. What do you think about this stuff about mammoths, Oscar?
Kate Walker, my place is not to pass comment on human dreams and utopia. My place is here in my place.
Sometimes I wonder. See you later.
See you, Kate Walker.
Don't need that anymore. Hi there, Oscar.
Good day to you, Kate Walker.
That's it, Oscar. I've wound the train up. Now we can leave.
That's impossible, Kate Walker.
Why, Oscar?
Soon we shall be confronting extremely cold temperatures, Kate Walker. We shall need coal to keep ourselves warm.
This time you're not wrong, Oscar. It is a bit nippy.
As soon as you have filled the coal car, we can set out again, Kate Walker.
I'll see what I can do. At the end of our journey, we're going to find Siberia, aren't we, Oscar?
Kate Walker, please,
I have not been designed to ask such questions. I am an automaton. I know, Oscar. I get the picture. Oscar... Do you think Mr. Vorarlberg is well enough to answer my questions?
Better than me, anyway, Kate Walker.
I guess you're right. See you later.
See you, Kate Walker.
Not right with this machine. Hans?
Yes, Kate?
Hans, why are you so eager to find Syberia?
I don't know, Kate. I've been looking for it for so long.
You know what? I'm so happy to be here, to follow you in pursuit of your dreams.
My dreams are now your dreams, Kate Walker.
Okay, so I find the coal, then we leave.
Do hurry, Kate.
See you later, Hans.
Yes, see you later.
Candy machines. Good day to you, sir. My name is Kate Walker.
Oh, you're American, aren't you? An American in a hole like this. Don't see that every day. Well, I am Colonel Emilyov. I am, in my capacity, in charge of the administration of this jurisdiction.
My friend who's with me came by here once. His name's Hans Varlberg. You don't know him, do you?
I haven't been here for long.
We just arrived by train. What an intriguing town. I'm impatient to visit it, Colonel.
There's not really much to see. There's this and that, but really there's just white, infinite white, like a desert blurring into the sky. Nothing but white till you reach the furthermost tip of the frozen Russian hinterland. Welcome to the last bastion of civilization, ma'am.
Tell me, Colonel, are there a lot of trains that pass through here?
Not really. But then, I've not been here for long.
There aren't any other travelers just passing through here?
Passing through to where, Miss Walker? After this stop, there's nowhere left to go.
We're going to keep on going, pushing northeast. A great journey to an improbable place. I actually think I'm just keeping an old man company in pursuit of his final dream.
Ah. People like you, Miss Walker, end up never going home.
Colonel, my train needs coal to continue my journey. Do you know where I can find some?
There's a dispenser outside. Feel free to fill her up, Miss Walker. Courtesy of the state.
And how do I operate this, machinery?
Just pull the handle and the coal drops down all by itself. Automatic, see? Totally automatic.
That coal machine doesn't seem to want to work.
Ah. In that case, you're going to have to wait.
Wait? How long?
Oh, a week. Maybe two. Maintenance doesn't come calling too often.
Tell me, Colonel, why is there a gate blocking off the staircase leading to the lower part of the town?
Low down is low down, and high up is high up. People who are low down got different points of view from those who are high up. Different kettle, different fish, if you get my meaning, Miss Walker.
How do I get down there, then?
Not the most advisable of moves. All the undesirables on the plateau wash up in our little town sometime. And I'd rather any lowlife stay down low.
I don't think I understand, Colonel.
I'm just a soldier, Miss Walker, carrying out a soldier's orders.
Colonel, would you have the key to the gate?
No, not anymore. Must have lost it earlier. where I was wasting my time on that dang music machine. Who can say?
Hey, it isn't my fault.
You being here has upset my usual timetable and general routine. If you hadn't been here, I wouldn't have gone out, and then I wouldn't have lost the key.
So you haven't got the key, then?
Sorry to say. If I had it, I'd give it to you. A gate's made for opening, after all.
And, of course, there's no double.
Got to wait for maintenance to make their call, Miss Walker. In a week or two.
Right. I'll leave you to get on with your business, Colonel.
Not much left to get on with.
Hi, my name's Kate Walker.
Hi, my name is Malka.
I'm Kate Walker, and you are Malka who?
Malka, just Malka.
Do you know how that machine over there works?
No, Kate Walker.
Maybe you've seen other people use it.
Yes, when the trains stop, but as they aren't stopping...
Why is there a gate that stops us going any lower?
It's not a gate that stops you going down. It stops people going up.
I see.
The old colonel says that people down here are all lowlife.
Do you know who's got the key to the gate?
If you give me a present, I'll tell you, Kate Walker.
I'd love to, but you're down there and I'm up here.
Well, you'll just have to find a present that comes from up there.
Do you want to look around the train?
Are you going to take me away with you on a journey?
No, I can't do that, Malka. You know why.
In that case, I don't want to see your train.
I understand, Malka. Let's not talk about it again. Tell me right now what you want. It'll be much easier.
I really want katalas, Kate Walker. They've got some in the shop.
Katalas? What's that?
Katalas! That's what they are. Candies! You don't know them? They're great!
I'm going. I'll go see what I can do.
I'll wait for you down below, Kate Walker.
Colonel Emiliov.
Ah, Miss Walker.
I know where your key is, Colonel.
Oh, it's not my key. That's state property, Miss Walker. I'm just an old soldier.
You must have dropped it. There's a kid down there says it's hers now.
Going to be no picnic getting it back then, huh?
Oh, she looks sweet enough. And I'm sure she never says no to treats and presents.
So everything's got its price then, Miss Walker.
Colonel, you can't repair it, can you? I really need coal, you know?
No, sorry. All that mechanical gubbins, motors, engines, not my thing. That's a maintenance job for a maintenance man.
Right. I'll leave you to get on with your business, Colonel.
Not much left to get on with.
I'll need some change. Nothing I can do. It's locked. This thing's stuck. Hi there.
Oh, so you're still here then?
Malka, I think I've found what you're looking for.
Throw it down, Kate Walker. Yuck! These fish are gross. It's katalas that I want, not these pukey fish candies. Whoever thought of making candies out of real fish?
Hi there.
Yes, Kate?
I think this time you won't be disappointed.
I can't wait to taste them, Kate Walker. Catch! You've only got one chance.
Kate Walker is in trouble. We've got to go look for her. Find someone. I don't know who. Someone spunky.
Yes, sir.
We've got Nick Canton, a detective. He's already worked on some tricky problems. He was good.
Yeah. He might just be the ticket.
Take care of it right now, John. Get him out there.
Right, sir.
Hell, what is going through that kid's head?
Yeah.
Hello, Canton? We've got a job for you, how shall I put it? A special job.
Weird vehicle. Do you like your candies, then?
Not bad.
Do you have any family, Malka?
I'm big enough to take care of myself.
Hey, don't get mad. It was just a question.
And anyway, of course I've got family. Zirkos, he takes care of me. Because my mama, she's dead.
Tell me, is Zirkos kind to you?
Yes, very. He is my friend.
Has he been living in the village for long?
When my ma and me came here, Zirkos looked after us. That was a long time ago, you know.
Yeah, I understand.
No, you don't. You must be really rich, and you must have thousands of friends in America. So, what are you doing here, Kate Walker?
I don't know. I'm miles from home, and I don't really know where I'm going. It's crazy.
Yes, Kate Walker, but there are loads of people who don't know where they're going. And they are all crazy, too.
Actually, I'm going to Syberia. That suits you as a destination?
If one day you return to America, you must take me with you, Kate.
Do you know a place called Syberia?
It's a land. They talk about it in kid stories. It's so far away it probably doesn't exist anyway.
From what I've heard, there's fields of blue grass as far as the eye can see. And mammoths.
That's not right. Grass is green. Or yellow in the fall. Bluegrass is silly.
Either way is fine with me, Malka.
You really are a strange lady, Kate Walker.
Do you know who could show me how this coal machine works?
No, it's an old machine, Kate Walker, and it smells.
Maybe there's someone who knows how this machine works?
Not Zirkos. He's too small to press the button. The Berghoff brothers, they must know. They know everything. But I don't like them. They are not nice.
Why do you say there are bad guys here?
The Berghoff brothers are liars and thieves. And they're nasty and they smell. Especially the little one that walks like a penguin.
You shouldn't make fun of people, Malka.
The big one isn't nasty, though. He's really stupid. A big dumb Yuki.
The Burghoff brothers could maybe give me a hand.
Why not? They're as dirty and smelly as the machine you want to mend.
I'm gonna see what I can find further on. Thanks, Malka.
As you like, Kate Walker.
Let's see. Oh, there's no more gas. That's the problem. A petrol-driven generator. Now, where could I find some fuel? Something's not right with this machine. Out of luck. The can's empty. I'm gonna see if I can find somewhere to fill it. Really a bit too cold. This path must lead to the monastery. Pity it's so far away. Maybe I can stop off on my way back from Syberia. Oscar?
Yes, Kate Walker?
No change, Oscar?
My gear systems and articulations are functioning like a dream, thank you. And you, Kate Walker, how are your functions?
Nothing too complicated, Oscar. I'll manage.
You sound so far away. Come back soon, Kate Walker.
I'm not very far away, Oscar. I'll come and talk to you face to face.
Honestly, I mean to say, what is it this time? Shut it, right? You hulking jerry roll, or else you'll be answering to me. And what is it now?
Good day, sir.
Don't go in telling me. What can I do for you, ma'am?
My name's Kate Walker. I just got here.
A pretty little thing so far from home. Where are you from, lovebird?
From New York.
New York, eh? Hey, well, I never. You traveling alone, ma'am?
No, I'm traveling with two companions. I came by train.
Very nice. Very nice.
I came by train and...
So we sewn, me and my bro. Nice machine. No, really. No ration tin can, that baby, or no?
Nice train. Nice. Nice. Choo-choo.
Yeah, actually, it belongs to one of my friends.
Must be very rich, your friend, eh?
Choo-choo.
Not really. He built the train to go looking for to realize a kind of dream of his.
Dreams, eh? Hey, very interesting. What kind of dream needs a pretty train like that, eh? If it's not a personal question.
Choo-choo.
A childhood dream.
Tell me more.
I need coal for my train, but the coal dispenser has run out of gasoline. I thought you might be able to sell me a bit of fuel.
So, you're already leaving? Sorry, we ain't got no gas. Ain't got no gas at all.
But what's that motor noise behind you, then?
Ah, yeah. That works on electricity, see, miss?
And that smoke works on electricity, too?
What you say ain't your business, miss. Take care of your own backyard and leave me and my brother here to work.
Yeah. Leave Igor and Ivan to work.
But I need some gas, that's all.
We ain't got none. N-O-G-A-S. No gas.
N-O. No. No gas. No gas.
If I don't get some gas, I can't get any coal, and my train is just going to stay here blocked in this station.
And so what do you want from us?
Hey, sir, I really need some gas, and looks like you've got some here.
Oh, patootie, don't know the meaning of no, as in no, we ain't got none.
No gas.
Sir, I'd like to...
Look, we ain't got no time to waste with you, sugar mitts. Try not being quite so pushy. You're starting to give me and my brother ideas, right?
I see.
Be a pity if something nasty happened to you, my little pouty lips.
Seeing as you don't seem to want to help me.
You might have a point there, my flower. Goodbye now.
No. Goodbye.
Hi, Malka. You want to talk to me?
To you, yes.
Malka, do you know anyone who has gas here?
No, Kidwalker.
You see, I need gas to get that coal contraption working.
Not me. I don't touch that machine. It smells.
I'm going to see what I can find further on. Thanks, Malka.
As you like, Kidwalker.
That doesn't work. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, milady, and welcome to the famous Circus Cabaret, haven of all known pleasures and human arts. How may I be of service to you?
I've just arrived here. My name's Walker, Kate Walker. You have a charming little town.
Well, Miss Walker, allow me to wish you a charming sojourn in our charming town.
Oh, I'm afraid I won't be around long. I've got to get going again soon. Mr. Circos, say, do a lot of trains pass through here?
Not now. Course, once upon a time, that line was quite a thoroughfare. Now, it's good as abandoned. People going to know you in town, Miss Walker.
This is one strange town you live in, Mr. Circos.
Only folks come to this town are folks just passing through. Often as not, cagey folk. Come here buying and selling or wheeling and dealing and having themselves a fine old time. After this town, there's nothing but snow, Miss Walker.
The monastery up there. Does anyone live there?
Oh, the old patriarch and a few monks must still be hanging around. Rarely get out at all. Never see them around town.
Mr. Circos, I really need to get some coal to continue my journey. But the generator that operates the coal dispenser has run out of gasoline.
Sorry, my lovely. Here you will find the finest range of vodkas known to man. The sweetest distillations from the furthest flung corners of our Russian holy land. But vodka, of course, only stokes the heart. And belly, no good for generator fuel.
Mr. Circos, those horses on the stage are strangely familiar.
Before, I had a performing monkey, but he died at the end of the fall. climate here's too rough and tumble for intelligent animals. Without my monkey, my cabaret was a sham. But the show must go on, so I dug out these old automatons. Been pretty successful in their time. Let's get them back on stage, I said. It's their mechanism, though, very delicate to regulate, takes several hours. But I invite you, Miss Walker, to watch my new act, Horsebreaker to Mechanical Stallions.
Your clockwork horses, Mr. Sirkos. They look so like something a dear friend of mine might have made.
Maybe your dear friend is my dear friend. What's his name?
Hans. Hans Vorarlberg.
Hans Vorarlberg! Well, I never. It's been years since I've had any news of him. How's he going?
Very well. We're traveling together.
Oh, Miss Walker, can you tell Hans to come up here? Make an old showman mighty happy. If he could turn a screwdriver to them there clockwork horses, 'cause I don't know diddly about automatons.
Sure, I'll pass on the message. But I can't promise he'll come. We're kind of short of time, Mr. Sirkos, you understand?
Of course, Miss Walker. But tell him anyway. Would sure make my day.
See you again sometime, Mr. Sirkos.
Hope to see you back here to catch my horses in action.
Colonel Emiliov.
Ah, Miss Walker.
The generator's dry. There's not a drop of gas.
Not a drop of gas, huh? That's strange. Because as far as I know, no one's ever used the coal dispenser.
Luckily, I've got a jerry can. Is there somewhere I can fill it up, Colonel?
Have to wait for maintenance. They fill the generator from time to time.
Yeah, I know. Next week, or the week after, or sometime next blue moon. A generator down below with some kind of coal-dispensing gizmo on top. Where will the technological revolution end?
Oh, he's no more crazy than a clockwork locomotive that needs coal, my dear.
We're going to Syberia, an island far across the Russian continent. It's one long journey. We're going to need plenty of material. What do you think?
Siberia Island? Never heard of it. I'm in no position to advise you, I'm afraid.
Right. I'll leave you to get on with your business, Colonel.
Not much left to get on with.
Nothing I can do.
You again?
Yep, little old me again. They might see me.
Hey, no! No! Ah! You clam brain blubber bag! Wait till I catch you!
Nothing I can do. It's locked. Yuck! This machinery stinks to high heaven. Excuse me, sir. Are you sleeping?
What do you want?
I've got a little something to say to your brother.
Ivan, he, leave me all alone here. My brother, abandoned me.
God, how I pity you, Igor.
Dumb animal! All the cash it might have brought me gone up in smoke!
There is Ivan. Ivan will be happy to see you. You know, go, Missy.
What? You let the Yankee leave? You are a Yuki brain, Igor. A lung shack Yuki brain.
That was a close call. He's back. It's better that I don't go.
So what do you want from me now, Miss Sticky Fingers?
Gas belongs to state. Russian state. Not my gas.
Okay, say nothing else, right? To the state. It belongs to the state, blobhead.
I don't think that I will be very well received. No point doing that. She's got a full tank now. The generator's working. Now I just have to get the coal up there. Hi, Malka. You want to talk to me?
To you, yes.
Malka, I finally managed to get that machine working.
So, now you must smell bad too, Kate Walker.
I tell you, that's manners.
Does that mean you're going?
Yeah. I've got to carry on with my journey.
Have a nice trip.
I'm gonna see what I can find further on. Thanks, Malka.
As you like, Kate Walker.
Something terrible has happened.
Calm down, Oscar. What's happened?
Mr. Vorarlberg has disappeared.
What?
He was in the train, and now he isn't.
Don't panic, Oscar. He can't have gotten far. I'll go and round him up.
He is not in the best of health, Gatewalker. And it is so cold.
I know, but calm yourself down. I'll go and look for him right away. Hi, Oscar.
Oh, please, Kate Walker, do be quick.
Oscar, what's going on?
Please do hurry, Kate Walker. Hans Vorarlberg seems to be running out of steam.
Oscar, what's going on?
He is not in the best of health, Kate Walker, and it is so cold.
Colonel.
What is it now, little miss?
Colonel, I've repaired your coal machine, and I've managed to open the gate.
This time I'll turn a blind eye, but you have violated state-registered property, Miss Walker. Maintenance won't like it, that's for sure. But then again, we see them so rarely these days. Anyway, you won't get any trouble from me.
I'm looking for a friend of mine. You wouldn't have seen him by any chance.
Sorry. I have not seen anyone.
My friend Hans got out of the train without telling me.
You mean he disobeyed orders?
He's not so young anymore. And our driver is a stickler for the rules. Passengers should not just get off the train for no reason. We have a long journey to make.
It's true your driver did seem a bit, how would you say, uptight.
Excuse me, Colonel, but I have to go out for a while.
Do what you have to do, Miss Walker.
Would you have a second you could spare?
Oh, so you're still here then?
Malka, have you seen my friend Hans? He's not in great shape. I've got to find him.
The little man? Yes, I've seen him. He's kind. He told me about mammoths and faraway places.
So you have seen Hans. Where is he?
He went to Serko's place. He said, I'm just going to drop in on an old friend.
I'm going to see what I can find further on. Thanks, Malka.
As you like, Kate Walker.
So, Kate Walker, have you located Mr. Vorarlberg?
No, Oscar, not yet.
Do hurry. His health is delicate. And it is so rude and cold outside.
I'll find him, Oscar. Trust me on this one.
Syberia! Syberia! Oh! Oh.
How's it going?
Father, Hans doesn't want to stay in the attic anymore. What happened? It's not his fault.
How's it going?
Your brother's a good-for-nothing imbecile, Anna. You hear me? A feeble idiot.
How's it going?
Syberia.
Kate Walker, what does all this mean?
I don't know, Oscar. Hans has had a kind of fit, a kind of delirium. His health isn't exactly 100% right now.
Why, that's simply awful, Kate Walker. We must do something. Things cannot go on like this.
Please, calm down. I'll see what I can do.
Okay, Kate Walker, but do hurry.
Oscar?
Are you still here, Kate Walker? Mr. Vorarlberg needs you terribly. Please do not procrastinate.
Oscar, is this the first time that Mr. Vorarlberg has had an illness like this?
I don't know Mr. Vorarlberg any more than you do, Kate Walker. I am only an automaton, after all. A machine born of creative genius. The feeling of concern I feel for my creator at this precise moment is merely the result of a wheelwork combination designed to produce just this effect.
I don't like it when you talk like that, Oscar. If we go now, Oscar, we're sure to find someone who can help us on the way.
Nothing of the sort, Kate Walker. The rest of our journey is long and perilous. What will we do if we encounter no help along the way?
I guess you're right. Oscar, I should go try and get help in this town.
Sadly, Kate Walker, there is clearly no doctor here.
There must be someone. What do people do here when they're sick? Hans isn't feeling so great, Oscar. You've got to help me treat him.
I do not have sufficient knowledge of human mechanics. The human body presents a somewhat complex system, Kate Walker.
Okay. Of course I understand. I'll try to find someone competent.
Please do hurry, Kate Walker. Hans Vorarlberg seems to be running out of steam.
As soon as I find help, I'll come back, Oscar. Right. I'm going to look for help.
Yes, do hurry up, Kate Walker.
Hi there, Oscar.
Good day to you, Kate Walker.
I need your help.
Kate Walker, I haven't a minute to lend you. I must remain entirely at Hans Vorarlberg's disposal. He really is doing very poorly. I am sorry.
Oscar, I'm going into town to look for help.
Okay. I'll wait for you, Kate Walker.
I'll be back soon.
Okay, Kate Walker.
Colonel, please, can you help me?
What can I do for you, Miss Walker?
Would you have something to treat a fever? My friend is sick.
I'm sorry. I sold my last pills last week.
Is there a doctor around here, or a pharmacy or something?
Around these parts? That would surprise me. They say the monks up there can patch a man up. At least people around here go up there sometimes.
Thanks for all your help, Colonel.
The pleasure is all mine, Miss Walker.
Malka?
Yes, Kate?
My friend Hans is very sick. He needs taking care of.
Oh, otherwise he's going to die, isn't he? Like Mama.
I don't know. He wants to get to the end of his journey so badly.
Sometimes that is not enough, Kate.
Since he was really young, Hans has dreamed of a land called Syberia.
Siberia doesn't exist. It's just a story they tell kids to make them sleep. And I'm no kid anymore.
I believe the story, though, Malka.
So, you're going to have to help your friend, Cape.
Tell me, do you know anyone who could help heal my friend Hans?
Zirkos has special tonics in his bar.
No, I need a real doctor.
Then you'll have to go to the monastery.
I suppose there are monks at the monastery.
That's right. Monks with big black robes. They're really creepy.
There's nothing to be afraid of. As monks, they must be good men. And you tell me they can treat Hans?
The patriarch is a stern old man. He won't treat your friend if you don't follow the monastery rules.
How do you know that, Malka?
He wouldn't look after Mama straight away, because of the rules. That's why she's dead.
I'm sorry, Malka. Howdy, Mr. Syrkos.
Good day to you, Miss Walker. How's our friend Hans Vorarlberg coming along?
Not great news.
Ah, well, if I can be of service. Whatever you require, don't hesitate to shout.
Mr. Syrkos, I'm worried about Hans's health.
Dang, it's all my fault. Never should have asked him to do me that favor.
What do you mean, favor?
No major work or anything, just to get my wind-up Broncos bucking again.
Oh, don't blame yourself. Hans was already ill before he came to see you. You've got nothing to do with it. Mr. Syrkos, you wouldn't know someone who could treat Hans Vorarlberg, would you?
Oh, not many pill-pushers around here. Guess there's always the monks.
The monks, you say?
People around here say the patriarch of the monastery has healing powers. They also say he's a dingaling, a bit of a fanatic, if you know what I mean.
Well, whatever. I have no choice. Mr. Syrkos, could you please introduce me to the patriarch of the monastery?
Want my opinion. Best stay right away.
Oh, why's that?
Have you ever heard a showman and a priest sing a duet together? They think my cabaret is a den of debauchery, and that I'm a funky old miscreant luring lambs from the altar.
Really, Mr. Syrkos, we're not in the 19th century anymore.
But we're not too far here, Miss Walker. Believe me, best I don't put my finger in that pie.
Do the monks have a telephone?
They don't even have electricity. You'll have to go up there in person, Miss Walker. Then try to convince them to take care of your friend.
How do you get up to the monastery?
When you go out of here, turn right. You can't miss it.
Thanks a lot. It's colder than the North Pole out there, Mr. Syrkos. Do I have to go up to the monastery on foot? There isn't some other form of transportation?
Don't even think about it, Miss Walker. Only pony can make it up there is Shank's pony. You're going to have to use your feet, I'm sorry to say.
It's really cold round here. I can't go to the monastery dressed like this.
Dead right, Miss Walker. Best to be careful in these temperatures.
You wouldn't have something warm to lend me, would you, Mr. Syrkos?
not gonna be easy, what with you having mighty different vital statistics and all, ma'am.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Please excuse me. I'm going to try to find some clothes someplace. I've got to
go.
Mighty... Mr.
What can...
There's maybe some warm clothes in your music hall wardrobe.
A few years ago, I had the pleasure of employing a mighty pretty singer who shared your dimensions, Miss Walker. I'm afraid the costume she wore that night might not lend much protection from the cold.
Yeah, of course. I'm a dope.
Go.
Hi, Mr.
What?
If you luck out and find some clothes, could you be sure to let me know, Mr. Sirkos?
Why, certainly, Miss Walker. I certainly will. Go.
Mr.
What?
Where could I find some warm clothes, Mr. Sirkos?
The general store, my dear. Home to everything.
Tell me, Mr. Sirkos. It was you who took in that little girl Malka into your care, wasn't it?
I just couldn't bear to leave a little girl like that.
What happened to her mother?
Oh, a gypsy woman fleeing God knows what monkey business. She got here half dead and crazed with fever.
The monks helped her, isn't that right?
You could say that. When they stopped being high and mighty, they took her up to their monastery for treatment. But it was far too late for the poor girl. Them old crows make up their own rules. They'd leave a man to rot rather than get their habits dirty. I don't like them one bit, Miss Walker.
What rules are you talking about?
It's a phony old custom. To decide whether a dying man is actually dying at all, the patriarch of the monastery looks at the patient's face before deciding yay or nay.
But how? I don't understand.
They kind of make this print of the face on a piece of cloth, you know, like the shroud of Jesus in the Bible.
I must confess, I don't really understand this shroud story.
You'll see, just outside the village, the monks have put this kind of iron box. A box containing a pile of linen sheets. When you put one of these sheets over the face of the sick man, it has the curious property of soaking up all his sweat and juices. So effective it is that all the features of his face can be seen on the cloth.
And so the old patriarch looks to this print to form his diagnosis?
At least what he can judge is whether that face on the shroud is sick enough to get dragged up those rocks to the monastery and be treated by him.
I suppose anybody can take a cloth from the crate if he needs it?
You suppose wrong, Miss Walker. One person has charge of the distribution of the said shrouds, and that's Malka. She sure is proud of her position. The patriarch himself gave her the responsibility, and that kid ain't giving it up for no man, believe me.
I've got to go now.
Go quickly, Miss Walker, and good luck.
Mighty kind, Mr. Sirkos. Tell me.
How is it going?
He told me why they couldn't treat her at the monastery.
Yes, Kate.
Sometimes, people get too sick and there's nothing that can be done.
Is your friend too sick?
I hope he isn't.
I'm going to help you, Kate.
Can you help me, Malka?
Only if your friend is a little bit sick. Not too much or you'll be sad.
We'll see. Let's give it a try, you know? Like for your mother, with the monks.
On the road to the monastery, there's a kind of box with sheets. The monks call them shrouds. I'm going to give you a token so you can get one. It's very important, Kate Walker.
Then what do I do with this shroud?
Take it and lay it over your friend's face.
Okay, I'll give it a try. Thank you for your help.
Come back and see me. I like you, Kate.
It's been barricaded. These folks don't like people just dropping in uninvited. Too cold. I'll be needing some warm clothes. I'll be dressed like this. I'd better not hang around too much outside. Colonel, please, can you help me?
What can I do for you, Miss Walker?
I want to go up to the monastery, but it's so cold outside. Would you have some warm clothes to loan me?
Maybe so. I might find what you want up in the attic. I'll get the ladder out.
I'll pay you for what I use, of course.
Don't you worry, Katyushka. You're a true ray of sunshine in this dusty old shop. And we don't see sunshine here every day. You'll find something that'll fit you in the attic, I'm sure. There you go, miss. I can't climb up there anymore.
Now, where to find someplace appropriate to slip into this? How's it going?
Your brother's a good-for-nothing imbecile, Anna. You hear me? A feeble idiot.
At last, a bit of privacy, for once. Toasty, and not unelegant even. Hi there, Oscar.
Good day to you, Kate Walker.
Oscar, I know where to get help for Mr. Varlberg.
Where, Kate Walker?
At the monastery, up there, at the top of that rocky crag.
So, Kate Walker, what are you waiting for? Why are you still here?
Oscar, I...
We have already wasted enough time, Kate Walker. I will tend to Mr. Varlberg during your absence.
Oscar... I admit that gloomy monastery does give me the creeps. Do you think you could go with me? I'd feel much better.
And Mr. Vorarlberg, who will take care of him? Did you think of that, Kate Walker?
Yeah, of course. See you later, Oscar. I'll be back soon.
Okay, Kate Walker.
Right now, I'm ready to take on the frozen north.
Why, it suits you like a dream, Miss Walker. You're a beautiful little snow fairy.
Our route is still long, and my friend is suffering. I don't know what to do.
Siberia is hellish cold at this time of year, Miss Walker. And journeys take an age. Your friend isn't in the prime of youth anymore.
From what I've heard, Colonel, the patriarch of the monastery is some kind of healer.
I'm just an old Cossack, and to me there's only one real remedy for everything. A good shot of vodka.
And that'd finish off poor Hans for sure. I was told the patriarch of the monastery can diagnose illness if he's shown a cotton sheet marked with the feverish face of the patient. What do you think about that, Colonel?
Here in Mother Russia, Katyushka, there are stranger tales to be told.
Thanks for all your help, Colonel.
The pleasure is all mine, Miss Walker.
Excuse me, I'm sorry to disturb you, sir?
Blessed art thou, my sister. What can I do for you?
My name is Kate Walker, and my train is currently at the station in Romansburg.
Oh, Romansburg. Pretty town, but not the kind of town for pretty strangers. Pretty solitary strangers.
I don't intend to hang around long, brother. I'm looking for someone with a medical background, someone who can tend to the sick.
Our patriarch is a remarkable doctor, my sister. He cures bodies as well as souls.
You couldn't help me, could you, please?
I am but a simple monk. You have to go see our patriarch yonder in the monastery.
I'm traveling with an old man, Hans Vorarlberg, and...
Vorarlberg. Did you say Vorarlberg, my sister?
You know him?
No, but I know someone else. Can you hear? It is the sweet song of the Merula Alba. If only I could catch a glimpse. Such a rare, pretty bird. Few are they who say in truth they have spied her beauty. It is probably seeking some other Merula Alba.
What is a Merula Alba?
A rare bird. It can never be seen, as it is as white as snow. They say that when a man sees it, his mind clears, and his intelligence grows and grows.
My friend is very ill, you know.
It is God's will. God's will. What can I do, my sister? What can I do?
Maybe you could visit him at his bedside.
Never, my sister, never. I would incur the wrath of our Lord and Patriarch.
You say that I could find someone to help me. Up there, at the monastery.
Yes, at the monastery, oh yes.
You live in the monastery, I suppose.
That is right, my sister.
Are there many of you up there?
A few old monks. Few are those who heed the calling in this age.
Tell me, what have we got to do to get into the monastery?
You must pull the rope that rings the bell, my sister, but not too hard, or you will scare the birds. Don't scare them. A monk will show you in.
Thank you. I rang at the monastery, but there was no reply. Maybe they don't want to let me in. Can you tell me, is there another way in?
There is no other way, my sister.
Why won't they let me into the monastery?
Dura lex, sed lex.
I'm sorry?
The law is hard, but it is the law, my sister.
What law?
I don't like questions, my sister. The law is the law is the law.
I rang the bell, but the monk at the door doesn't seem to want to show me in.
There are rules. Rules and traditions to respect here. Respect.
What rules? What traditions?
That some people are less worthy than others.
Okay. So how does that monk up there make an opinion about my worthiness by just looking at me?
It is not a question to ask, my sister.
You're telling me that I'm not worthy to enter your monastery?
I didn't say. No. I just wash dirty laundry, that's all.
Yes, you did say that. You implied I wasn't worthy.
Femina inconcessus.
I don't understand Latin.
Latin, like the birds. Erythacus rubicola, picus viridis, merula alba.
You speak Latin, then?
Oh, monk's Latin. Pigeon Latin.
You seem to know the Latin names of birds.
Pretty birds. Pretty birds.
Picus viridis?
Woodpecker.
How about Erythacus rubicula?
Robin red breast.
And Merula alba?
White raven, my sister.
Femina inconcessus?
Women. Forbidden. No.
Right. I get it. Because I'm a woman, I'm forbidden access to the monastery. Now I understand.
That's the rule, sister. I can't change the rules.
Of course, brother. Women are the source of all sin. Isn't that so? I must absolutely find a doctor for my friend.
I just do the laundry, my sister. That is all. Down here, there are some doctors. And others do the laundry. You are going to make me late. Do you hear? It is the Merula alba again.
Why won't you help me?
I must finish my chores before evensong, my sister.
I'm going now. I'll be back soon.
What?
Oscar, it's Kate.
Why here?
Everything okay, Oscar?
Nothing to report since our last exchange. Thank you. And you?
Let's see what happens.
Do hurry back, Kate Walker. Hans needs you.
I'm coming, Oscar. Don't get impatient. Colonel?
Ah, Miss Walker.
Colonel, you don't have one of those whistles for making bird noises among your many treasures here, do you?
A bird call? Why, I sell them by the truckload during the hunting season. I've got a whole collection of them. I think I've got just what you need somewhere. Aha!
Thanks for all your help, Colonel.
The pleasure is all mine, Miss Walker.
Excuse me, Oscar.
Ever on duty.
How you doing?
Everything is fine here. Thank you for inquiring.
Not much has changed.
Kate Walker, I am still waiting for you.
Time goes so quickly. I'll be there soon. Brother?
Yes, my sister.
There seem to be a lot of birds around here.
Yes, yes. But the only one that interests me is the meadowlark.
I've got to go now.
That is right, my sister.
And do you plan on returning it? Ever? Okay, no. And do you plan on returning it? Ever? Okay, no.
Can you hear? The Merula Alba. It is calling to me. Calling to me.
Dressed like this, I'd better not hang around too much outside.